We are the cast of Glass Onion, and we're going to take you through a scene from the film shot by shot.
You lucky people.
Any questions? If anyone can name the killer, tell me how they achieved the murder, and most importantly, what was the motive, that person wins our game. We have a murder mystery game within a murder mystery film.
Wait, what do we win?
What do you want?
I just thought maybe there was a prize or something.
All I remember thinking is just that Benoit was just so happy to be there.
Yeah. And I was so happy Benoit was there.
Can we work together?
Only one person can solve a crime, so if you got a theory, keep it close to your chest.
Oh. Every moment I would just flirt with Benoit.
At this point in the film, pretty much everyone else is unhappy, and Blanc, he is living his dreams. He's absolutely living his best life.
He doesn't want to be anywhere else.
Have we started already? Is it?
Well, the murder hasn't happened.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, why not? As Watson said to Holmes,
it was Birdie who planted a remote device on a crossbow in revenge for you stealing her signature Wren diamond.
It's just a delight to get given these lines and also to be in a room with this group of people. I just remember having lots of fun, lots and lots and lots of fun.
Sometimes when you read a script, a good script might give you a feeling like, oh, I can't wait to see that bit done. And when Blanc cuts in and calls the shot, I laughed out loud when I read it, and I was waiting and waiting for us to get to it.
Look at the seat arrangement. It triangulates Birdie just perfectly with that thing, which is loaded with a dummy bolt aimed directly at Mr. Bron.
Maddie did a really funny thing when you drew the line between the crossbow and me, and she was sitting just to my right, and she did this little thing where she looked at the crossbow and looked at the line and realized she was in it, and she just moved herself just a little to the right.
That is a vintage Jayhawk brand crossbow.
I loved watching everybody's reactions. I remember looking at Catherine, like her head was like, I couldn't stop laughing.
Catherine was one of the hardest people to keep a straight face.
I remember Bautista too, because he was so in his own world in that moment because of other dynamics happening at the table that he wasn't even concerned with what was happening with Benoit.
Nah, once you're dead, will we still be able to talk to you?
Yeah, I'm not playing dead the whole weekend, dude. Why is Ryan so good at awkward?
Dinner scenes are very difficult to shoot and get right and tone, but Ryan's thing is the awkwardness of the scene and the tension on the table, which you feel, and that's where the funny comes from.
It's much quicker to watch than it was that the process of it was two long days of us sitting in the same seat.
Because you had to cover every single
angle. You've got to cover everybody.
And you had so much dialogue.
Of course, there are other superfluous and rather clumsy clues. The hedgerow in the south garden, that spells the letter B. Birdie's room is the sacred chakra, which is the one block by guilt, blah, blah, blah. But the motive, yes.
The scene was longer, and it's been edited down, thankfully.
I mean, it was two pages or something. Mm. Like, he just whipped it out. Like, it was, you were, remember?
So to speak.
You guys. And you were so prepared, and it was unbelievable. Like, you didn't miss a beat.
It's nerve-wracking to stand up in front of these people. These are my peers, but it's wonderful dialogue, and it's just fun to do.
This crime clashed with the presence of Benoit Blanc.
Oh my God, that was the best. That is
good.
That is the best.
Thanks for watching a scene with us. It will only get better when you watch it yourself in The Glass Onion, only on Netflix.